Hello everyone, welcome to Serendipity in Quarantine. Today we are going to see second chapter of 9th standard NCERT called Is Matter Around Us Pure? So generally we heard purity considering objects like salt, ghee, milk. So these were consumable items, and common sense is that pure means it has no adulteration. But according to the scientist, all these things that are actually mixture of different substances, hence nothing is pure. Salt is pure if it is not adulterated, but scientifically it is still a mixture of sodium and chloride, hence it is not pure. Milk is mixture of water, fat and proteins. So pure substance consists of a single type of particle. In other words, the substance is pure single form of matter. In previous lecture we saw what was the matter. So matter contains various types of particles, and if a substance is made of only one matter, then it is pure. So let's see what is mixture. So mixture is considered more than one pure form of matter. For example, salt, it is scientifically named as sodium chloride, and it can be separated from water by physical process if it is dissolved in water. So what are the types of mixture? So consider matter A and matter B, and when they are mixed together they form uniform composition. So it is called as homogeneous matter, which is uniform. And if it is non-uniform, that means you can still see matter of another substance, then it is called as heterogeneous mixture. For example, mixture of oil and water, you can clearly see oil different than water. Next term is solution. So solution is a homogeneous mixture of two or more substances. So we daily drink lemonade, which is mixture of lemon juice and water. It is a solution. Soda water is also a solution of carbonated drink. So there are also types in solution: solid solution, that are alloys, and gaseous solution. For example, air. So alloys are mixture of two or more metals or non-metals. So if we consider brass, then it is alloy of 30% zinc and 70% copper. So alloys have still mixture because it contains various properties of its components. So solution has two components, solvent and solute. So the component which dissolves other component is known as solvent, and the component which gets dissolved in solution is called as solute. So for example, in case of mixture of water and salt, salt is solute and water is solvent. In sugar and water, sugar is solute and water is solvent. In solution of iodine in alcohol is known as tincture of iodine. So here iodine is solute and alcohol is solvent. In case of aerated drinks like thumbs up, Coca-Cola, the carbon dioxide gas is solute and water, which is liquid, is solvent. So what are various properties of solution? So solution is a homogeneous mixture. It contains particles which are only 1 nanometer. Nanometer is 10 raised to minus 9 meter in diameter. So they cannot be seen by naked eyes. So particles are very, very small. Also, if a beam of light is passed through the solution, then it is not scattered. Its path is not visible. Solute particles cannot be separated from mixture by process of filtration. Then it is called solution. There are types like concentrated solution and dilute solution. So if quantity of solute is very less, then it is dilute solution. And if it is very large, then it can be concentrated or saturated solution. Let us see scientific definition. At any temperature, if a solution that has dissolved as much solute as it is capable of dissolving, then it is called saturated solution. Means after certain point the solute does not get dissolved in the solution, then that solution will be called saturated solution. If you can experiment at home, you start dissolving sugar into water, at certain point the sugar will not get dissolved in water, then you will call it is a saturated solution of sugar. So but there are some solution which are less than saturation level, then they are called unsaturated solution. The amount of solute present in a saturated solution at any temperature is called its solubility. So if it has more soluble, then more solute can be get dissolved. The concentration of solution is the amount that is mass or volume of a solute present in given amount of solution. That is mass of solute divided by mass of solution into 100 is equals to mass of percentage of solution. Second topic, what is suspension? Non-homogeneous system in which solids are dispersed in liquid are called suspension. So in suspension, it is a heterogeneous mixture, but the solute particles that do not dissolve but remain suspended throughout the bulk of medium. If you take dirt or sand and you mix it water, you can still see suspended dirt particles in the water. So water is properties, it is heterogeneous, then its particles are so big that it can be seen with naked eyes, it scatters beam of light passing through it. Solute particles settle down when suspension is left undisturbed. If you keep that dirt water undisturbed, then that dirt will get settled at the bottom of the vessel. So there is type called colloidal solution. So colloidal solution, but it is what in which particles of colloid are uniformly spread throughout the solution and they are smaller in size, so they cannot be seen by naked eyes. For example, milk. So because there are small size of colloidal particles, they easily scattered beam of visible light, and this scattering of beam of visible light is called as Tyndall effect. So if you will take torch and pass it through water, it will not get scattered, but if you pass through milk, it will get scattered. This Tyndall effect is named after scientist Tyndall. It can be also seen if through canopy of dense forest, if there is mist of tiny droplets of water in the air, or you can see a hole through which sunlight comes into the air, you can see colloids of dust particles in the air. So what are the properties of colloid? Colloids are heterogeneous mixture. Size of particles of colloid are too small to be seen by naked eye, but big enough to scatter beam of light. They do not settle down when left undisturbed. So colloid is quite stable. They cannot be separated from mixture by process of filtration, but by process of centrifugation. So what is centrifugation? You take a solution in one container and rotate it at very high speed, then particles will get separated through the process of centrifugation. Centrifugal force applies on it and it separates the particle. Here there are some examples of common colloids. So when liquid is dissolved in gas, then that type is called aerosol. For example, fog, cloud, mist. When solid is dissolved in gas, it is also type of aerosol. For example, smoke, automobile exhaust. When gas is in liquid, for example, foam, it makes shaving creams, soap foam. When liquid is dissolved in liquid, then it causes emulsion. For example, milk, face cream, etc. So read this chart. So how can we separate components of mixture? If it is a heterogeneous mixture, then it can be separated easily by hand picking, sieving or filtration method. Means if you want to separate dirt from water, you can just filtrate it and some of the dirt particles will get separated. But if it is a homogeneous mixture, then they are required various methods. One of the method is called evaporation. if this is the solution and you start boiling the water, then the process of evaporation causes non-volatile component separate from volatile component of the solution. For example, if you take ink in water and start boiling it, then ink will get separated from water through the method of evaporation. How will we separate cream from milk? So nowadays we get skim milk, milk with fat, cream of milk. So the method of centrifuge is used. So it is used by using centrifuge machine, and then machine rotates that solution at high speed and it gets separated. So the principle of denser particles are forced to the bottom and lighter particles stay at the top when spun rapidly. How we can separate a mixture of two immiscible liquids? So if there are two immiscible liquids and they have different color or different properties, then layer forms. So we can remove it using the method like step cock. So if this is kerosene and water, then two different layers are formed. So if you open this cock until this level, then the water will be separated from kerosene. Then how to separate mixture of salt and camphor? So camphor is kapur, which is used in pujas. So it is submersible solid. It directly gets converted into gaseous state. So if you keep mixture of salt and camphor at a plate and heat it at some level, and block this passage through cotton plug, then that camphor will get sublimated and it will get solidified at the entrance of this vent. So this experiment will be performed at school. The process of component of mixture, the process of separation of component of mixture in which two different colors of liquids is there is called as chromatography. In Greek, chroma means color. So here we use the different colors of liquid to separate that water. So chromatography is technique used for separation of those solutes that dissolved in the same solvent but have different colors. For example, in case of drugs from blood, colors from dye, pigments of natural color, etc. How can we separate mixture of two miscible liquids? So miscible liquids get dissolved completely in the solvent. So the method of distillation is used. So what happens at distillation? You boil the solution at particular boiling point of the solute, then it starts getting evaporated, then it is passed through this water condenser. Here there is water surrounded by this pipe and it causes cooling down of this vapor, and that solute is get collected at this beaker. If we heat at the particular boiling point of one of the solute, then only that solute will get separated from this solvent. If there are two solutes and they have difference of boiling points very low, that is less than 25 Kelvin, then the fractional distillation process is used, in which fractional column is fitted between the distillation flask and condenser so that two different types of solute can be distilled. So here we are heating the solution at particular boiling point, but also one of the fraction column is extra component added so that only that component pure liquid gets accumulated through in this beaker. So how can we separate pure copper sulfate from impure sample? The method is called crystallization method. It is used to purify solid. So crystallization process that separate pure solid in form of its crystals from solution, it's called crystallization. So this technique is better than evaporation technique because in case you have evaporation, some of the solids get decomposed. For example, in case of sugar solution, sugar may get charred or because of heating, and some of the impurities may still remain in dissolved in solution even after filtration. And this method is better. So it is used to purify salt that we get from sea in the water. So what happens if, and also in case of alum, that is pitkiri, from impurity samples, that the crystals of that solid gets formed at particular surface and impurities will get separated from the pure substance. Water purification system of water in water works. So there is this large reservoir from which we get water at our home at tap. So what is the first method? Sedimentation tank, in which this large sediment gets settled at the bottom. So it allows solid to settle. Then it is passes to loading tank. So to sediment suspended impurities. Then they are passed to filtration tank. Here water is separated from fine sand, gravel, coarse gravel. And through this the water is passed so that it gets filtrated through natural filtration. Then chlorination is done, that is chlorine is added to this water so that it kills bacteria like E. coli. And then it is passes through pipes and it comes at our home through tap. So what are the types of pure substances? So basically they are classified either as elements or components. Robert Boyle, first scientist, used the term element. He defined that elements are basic forms of matter that cannot be broken down into simpler substances by chemical reaction. So elements are normally divided into metal, non-metal and metalloid. So we'll see properties of metal. So metals are usually lustrous, that is they have shine, they have silver, grey, golden, yellow color, they conduct heat, electricity, they are ductile, that means we can draw wires from the metal. Then they are malleable, that means if we hammer the metal then they can convert into thin sheets. Then they are sonorous, that is they make ringing sound when we hit them. For example, gold, silver, copper, iron, sodium, potassium. Mercury is the only metal that is liquid at room temperature. So remember this fact. Mercury is used in thermometers, and thermometers are recently very much is used considering this coronavirus pandemic. Then non-metals. So non-metals show properties like they have various colors, they are poor conductor of heat and electricity, they are not lustrous, they do not create sound, they are not sonorous, or they are not malleable, means they cannot be hammered into thin sheets. Some of the examples are hydrogen, oxygen, bromine, chloride, etc. And some elements which are intermediate properties between metal and non-metal, they are called metalloids. So these metalloids can be of various types. 11 elements are in gaseous state at room temperature called inert gases, and 2 elements are in liquid at room temperature, that is metal of mercury and non-metal called bromine. Then what is component? So component is a substance composed of two or more elements chemically combined with one another in fixed proportion. So what is the difference between compound and mixture? So mixture is just mixture of two elements, and but it does not form new component. But while here compound has new element react to form new compound. In mixture has variable composition, but compound has fixed composition. Mixture show properties of constituent substance. For example, if you make mixture of salt and water, the properties of salt and water does not change. But here in compounds, the property of the new compound is totally different than its components. Constituents can be get separated fairly easily in mixture by only physical methods like filtration. But in compounds, it requires chemical or electrochemical reactions. So here is the chart which divides and provides classification of matter into elements, compounds. Then in case of mixture, what is homogeneous and heterogeneous mixture, this can be used to revise this chapter. So if you like this video, please like, share and subscribe to this channel. Thank you so much for your time.